Welcome to Cat and Raven Designs. I'm a ho-ho.
And I'm Raven. I am not, in fact, a sweet treat.
I am most definitely a snack.
Cheap snack?
Yes, a cheap snack.
Cheap snack. Yeah, I'm bitter. I'm coffee. Welcome back to another entry in our anime-inspired series. Did you really think we were going to talk about Full Metal Alchemist in the last two episodes and not do a Full Metal Alchemist soap? Come on. We had to. So, we are coming in today for Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood inspired soap. And as previously stated in the prior two episodes, which I'll leave a link up in the iCard for the previous anime inspired soaps, I've only seen the anime. And I tried to watch the original Fullmetal Alchemist, but I liked Brotherhood a lot more, so I watched that one. That one is easily one of my favorite animes. But I haven't read the manga, don't at me, okay? I do my best.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, that one I haven't even attempted to read the manga, but I have seen both the original all the way through and Brotherhood all the way through.
Which one do you like better?
Brotherhood. But I my favorite character.
Don't you dare.
Oh, but she was so
don't
adorable.
You dare! No!
Edward!
No! I'll edit that out.
She was the goodest doggy. She was best puppy. Raven's about to kill me, guys. If looks could kill.
Well, let's get to some of the details here. So we've got our usual base, but before we dive into blending, let's talk about colors over here. So for our colors here, to represent Ed, we have Trial by Fire and Black Iron Oxide. And to represent Alphonse, I have Neutral Gray with just the barest hint of Titanium Dioxide. And over here is Celestial Silver with a little bit of Neutral Gray and a little bit more of Titanium Dioxide. So this is gonna lighten up once I blend it. For our fragrance, we have Nag Champa from Candle Science. Because Candle Science is our new fragrance bay.
It smells like a witch store.
It smells so good. It does smell like incense, yeah. Gosh, I miss witchy stores, like New Age stores. I barely see them anymore.
Being honest, the 90s indie and Etsy exists.
Yeah, but like I really liked going into the witchy store and like looking at all the little knickknacks and like the incense and just, oh.
So and little stones.
I bought stuff. I was a witchy gremlin, okay? I bought all kinds of little witchy things.
I mostly bought the little crystals and stones and whatnot.
Let's get to blending and then we'll talk about how we're going to do this. So we've got our usual base of oils here, and I've got my lye, distilled water, and sodium lactate in here. If you're new to our channel, we make bar soap, which is done with a combination of lye and oils in a chemical reaction called saponification, and then we use sodium lactate to make sure the bars harden up nice and release out of the mold easier.
And I'm not allowed to swear until after the blend.
Yeah. All right, let's get to blending. So I'm trying to keep to really minimal blending because I have two layers to do here. I want to make sure my last layer is not all set up before I get into it. So I suppose our first question, because we're gonna have one layer representing Ed and one layer representing Alphonse. So which should I do first? Because my thought is maybe I should do Ed first because he's shorter. So he'd be on the bottom.
I mean, he always struck me as bottom anyways.
Okay. I mean, are you wrong? No. He just wants Winry to top him. All right, so I gotta do some measuring. So let's start with our dear friend, Edward, here. This is gonna be inspired by Ed's coat, which I love his coat so much. I want his coat. Can I have his coat, please?
I don't want Ed's coat. It'll be too short and small.
Not like Ed's coat ripped off him. I'm gonna pour Alphonse later. So let's get this blended up and ready to go here.
Oh!
Yeah, I filled it real close. I got it. It's gonna be fine. All right, here we go. All trying to get, like, the perfect consistency.
As I was saying, I'm a lazy. Figured out how to do this overhead filming and still be able to sit on my.
Look, so long as it's still in focus and you're not, like, looking at other things, so you don't realize the camera's all. It's not the end of the world. Not how I do it, but you know. So, we're gonna start off by pouring Ed in here. So, what's one of your favorite characters from the show? I know, it's a hard question, like, how do you pick?
Edward!
You! That is not your favorite character!
She is actually my favorite
character. Just a goddamn troll. Nina is your favorite character?
She was my favorite character.
Then why would you take such delight in her misery?
It's not that I take delight in her misery, I take delight in everybody else's misery.
Fun fact. On the inside of Ed's watch, he has the date that they made the promise and burned down their house.
Mm-hmm.
What date is that? Earn your weeb card.
If you were a real fan, you'd know this.
It has to do with me, oddly enough.
I want to say it's like your birthday.
It is. October 3rd, on the inside of Ed's watch, that's my birthday. I remember the first time I watched it, and I was like, oh no, my birthday.
Is when they burned down their house.
I would say my favorite character is all of them. Every time I try to pick, there's too many, because it's like, Roy Mustang is my first choice, obviously. Your boy Roy. And then Risa Hawkeye, I love Ed, I love Alphonse.
My other favorite is it Hughes?
Hughes. Why do you like the unsettling, unhappy situations so much? I love Izumi Curtis, the Iron Wall of Briggs. I also love Major Armstrong. I love all of them. Now we're going to work on Alphonse. Hey, you know, my brother has a Full Metal Alchemist tattoo.
Yeah, he's got the...
The Ouroboros.
Yeah.
Hi, Brooder. I don't know if he watches. I think my sister-in-law watches, but I don't think Brandon does. Not really his deal, which is fine.
Oh, I'm sure he'll see this one once she's like, hey, hey!
They did a Full Metal Alchemist soap, you weeb! My brother's been on the channel before.
Yeah.
We had Brandon and Shirney come over and help us make soap. Poor things. Poor Sharuni. I think I felt the most bad for her.
Oh, because it was complete chaos and they're both engineers.
It was very chaotic. Well, not just that, but like she was not only having to deal with the chaos of like creating art as this is, but also like Brandon and I. He and I have always gotten along really well, so we're just sort of dorks together.
I would say you should probably be grateful that my brother and I don't live in the same state.
Oh?
Or that my sister-in-law and I don't live in the same state, for that matter.
Are they chaos like you?
Yes. When her and I get together, we're straight pure chaos.
So time for some poor porn. Now that the base is good to go, we have some embeds. So I have some melt and pour cogs and wheels to sort of represent the machinations of the homunculi underneath the city. Try and aim for two on each bar, if I can. Maybe, oh, crap. Crap. If you could do alchemy, what kind of alchemy would you do?
Fire! I cast fireball!
I suppose I should have seen that. I think I'd want to be like Ed and Alphonse, but like having not tried to bring my mom back from the dead, that'd probably be a good thing to try and avoid.
So like you want to be able to transfigure stuff?
Yeah. I mean, I think they can probably all do that.
I would imagine that would be, like, Alchemy 101.
Or maybe I could be, like, Dr. Marco and, like, help people. But I don't want to have, experimented on people. Not so much. This is gonna take so long. Oh, why did I sign up for this? It's gonna look really cool, though.
It is. I was wondering how you're gonna fit two of those per per bar.
Like these. Just jam them all up in there. So I suppose there's a question here. Now we've done Fruits Basket, we've done Oron High Host Club, we're doing Brotherhood, Full Metal Alchemist. We have one left that we're going to post. The other is one that we've done previously, so we're not going to do another video for it. So have fun going through the backlog and trying to figure out which one it is if you're not familiar with our work. But what else would you like to see in this collection? What do you think is the last one? Comment down below what you'd like to see. If this series goes over well and people like it, then we'll probably do it again next year. And we'd want to do new animes.
Though I would like to watch the animes before we try and do a soap for them.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea. I know, I've been trying to get you to finish watching Black Butler. I had you start watching Magus Bride with me.
I think if we do this again, another one I would like to do is either Madoka or Magical Girl Raising Project.
Oh god, Magical Girl soap, but like a dark Magical Girl soap?
Yes.
I would be down with that. I really like Madoka. It's really well done.
And I believe the other one, when you finally finished it, you're like, what the f*** did you have me watch?
Yeah, that was pretty solidly my opinion. You know, I watched Hunter x Hunter by myself, and I really liked that one.
Oh yeah, I watched that one ages ago.
Did you?
Yeah.
Oh.
I didn't finish it, but I got a decent ways through.
It was kind of a wild ride, if I'm gonna be honest.
Oh, Seven Deadly Sins.
Oh yeah, Seven Deadly Sins.
That we're current on.
As much as I occasionally find it extremely problematic. Not that some of the animes that we've done so far aren't also problematic in their own ways. I'm done!
Woohoo! I tried to talk her into glitter, guys, but she said no.
It's not a glitter soap. So we're gonna let this rest for about 24 hours or so. Because we haven't used this fragrance before, we'll see how it behaves. I think it's going to be set up pretty well, pretty quick.
Mm-hmm.
And then we will be back to split it into loaves, and then we will split it into bars and see how we did. So if there is an ad available with YouTube, we'll go ahead and let that run. Enjoy the art card in between. I have been taking art lessons on Skillshare. Hopefully that's showing in my work and the little ad stills. So with that, we'll be right back. See you in a sec. Welcome back. Loaf is ready to go. Split this into loaves. Excuse you. Pardon you, sir. Looking good so far.
Ooh.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Let's do this. All right. Let's see how we did. There we go.
Ooh.
Add an owl. Look at these drops.
Yeah.
High quality drops.
Yes.
Also glad that we put Ed on the bottom.
I mean, like I said, Ed just gives off bottom energy.
Again, I can't really say that you're wrong. Greg? Pardon you?
Jexcuse.
Manners, Greg. Manners.
Ooh.
Ooh. That looks like, okay, so you remember like the flames that you used to draw in like the 90s? Yeah. Early 2000s? That's what that shit looks like.
You're right. Oh no, this whole loaf is like that.
Guys, we give you 90s flames. Not the soap anyone asked for, but the soap we all deserve.
What?
90s flames.
Oh, it's like, nobody asked for Full Metal Alchemist, but you're getting Full Metal Alchemist.
I mean, that too, but
I kind of want to rewatch it again for like the 8th time.
Edward.
Stop! Hate you! If you've ever been in our Discord, you know how often Kat does this. Like, out to torture people.
Oh, you're happy you see me do it on Facebook.
You got banned on Facebook.
Only for 24 hours.
Are you unbanned now?
Yes, I am unbanned now.
Kat got banned from Facebook for calling out a transphobe. Kat got banned, not the transphobe.
Yeah, Facebook.
Ugh. Ooh, interesting. Happy You got some really good swirls. I'm so happy.
And you see, the first thing I did after the 24-hour ban was lifted was go back on Facebook. Somebody had responded to said person's comment, transphobic comment. And it was one of my friends, and so I was able to go back to that post and then continue to shit-talk the transphobe.
Did you report them for being transphobic?
Yes.
Good.
Their comment's still there.
Of course it is.
Hey. I'm just enjoying being a complete and utter dick to this transphobe at this point.
All I can say right now when it comes to social media bans and stuff is... at least
some Cheetos dust.
Been banned from like all kinds of social media, and he's not president anymore. I hope the next time I see his stupid face is while he's on trial, and the last time I see his stupid face is on the way to jail. Probably not. He's a rich person. Rich people go to the jail. When rich people go to the jail, when rich people go to jail, everything is probably not that bad for them.
Ooh,
it looks like a butt. Awesome. So, even the mini bars have a nice mix of both brothers plus a couple of gears. And once again, another loaf is completed, ready to go. So these will be available at the end of February as part of our dub/sub relationship collection, our anime-inspired collection. So that will be, say, February 26th, I think. At 8 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. It's the last Friday of February on catandravendesigns.com. Can't wait to see you there. So if you could, down in the comments, because we have one soap left to go, let me know what your favorite anime is that you think that maybe Kat and I should go and check out. So with that, this is your hydration reminder. Please go and grab your water bottle, take a sip, take three, and we will see you for the next video. Bye, everybody!